My interest in cortisone continued because of its great efficacy. I asked the folks in medicine to give it to Helen, and they said, no, we can't give it to her because her face will swell up. She'll gain weight, her skin will become thin, she'll get bleeding under the skin, her bones will weaken, and she'll get cataracts. Don't use cortisone for Helen. But cortisone remained the most promising medicine for her. I asked my professor colleagues to teach me more about cortisone. Well, they said it's produced by the adrenal glands of the body. There's two adrenal glands on top of each kidney. I said, you mean God put a poison into our body? Two glands to make a poison to our body. But don't the billions of people on Earth have it in their body then? And they said, yes. Well, they don't have cortisone side effects. So I began smelling stinking thinking.
Cortisol plays a very important role in regulating the immune system. If we didn't have cortisol, then the immune system would get too activated, and not only would it destroy foreign bodies or viruses or bacteria that got into the body, it starts to destroy your own tissue. So we need cortisol to help regulate the immune system so it doesn't get out of control, and that's a major purpose of cortisol in the body.
My medical school colleagues explained that cortisone has to be in the blood at all times, day and night, to sustain life. If it drops to zero, death threatens through the disease we call Addison's disease. President Kennedy had Addison's disease. He remained alive and active by taking cortisone daily. When do we observe side effects? Well, let's suppose somebody comes in with arthritis. We give them cortisone at sufficient concentrations to get rid of their arthritis. Then we get the side effects. But as God puts it in the body, it doesn't have side effects. When people give it to people, we have side effects. Therefore, people don't know how to give it to people. I go to the endocrinologist, and they teach me that hormones are regulators and have no side effects. I go to the pharmacology department. The professors there tell me that cortisone has side effects. But cortisone is a hormone. One must be telling a non-truth. So I concluded in the 1970s that cortisone doesn't have side effects, that people don't know how to give it to people. What we're observing as cortisone side effects is overdosing through lack of understanding.